You're listening to Five Before, a faith community podcast. Remember to subscribe so that you don't miss any new episodes. For more information, check us out at faithcommunitylc.com or look for our app on iTunes and the Google Play Store.
Good morning, everyone. I am so excited to be sitting next to my brother here on this beautiful Tuesday. And we hope you guys are having an awesome day. We hope you're having what has started out to be a great week. And he's trying to look at this. look, we are on the podcast, and he is watching the podcast. Who does that remind you of, Aaron? Ben Belangia. Listen, every Sunday I'm preaching right in front of him, and he watches it on his phone. And so I think Pastor wants to make sure he looks okay. He wants to make sure y'all ladies. I want y'all to remember now. He's not available anymore.
He is officially
about to get married. So it don't matter how you look, Pastor. It don't matter. You're a taken man. That does not matter. But it is awesome to have Pastor Duravius Colors with us from True Friendship Church. He is, honest to goodness, he's our sister church here.
That's
my brother. He is the one that that I just know that God has put in my life, and I hope he feels the same about
here.
Me.
Oh yes, definitely.
That we're in this thing for this community together.
That's right.
And we're going to work together on this thing, and we want to make sure our city knows these types of things are powerful. These connections, these kingdom connections. And so I'm really glad to have you today. You having a good week?
A great week.
Great week. He must have learned that from Eddie Turner, because just yesterday I came in and I said, "Hey, how are you?" He said, "I'm great." He said, "How are you?" I said, "I'm doing good." He said, "Up." He said, "We got to work on the way you're talking." He said, "You didn't say great, so you got to speak that greatness."
That's right.
So anyway, man, we're glad to have you guys today. And I'm going to read a couple of passages to you really quickly, and then I'm going to let Pastor Duravius encourage you with this as well today. But I just had a word that God dropped in my spirit today, and it was the word glad. The Bible says in Psalm 118, verse 24, it says, "This is the day the Lord has made." Now, we know this passage. We hear this over and over. You've heard people say, "Man, this is the day the Lord has made." And he says, "Let us rejoice and be glad." In it. Now, we don't think about that word very much, Pastor, but here's what I know. If I walk up to you today and I say, "How you doing today?" and you say, "I'm good," I'll say, "That's good." But if I walk up to you and if I say, "How you doing?" and you say, "I'm glad," I'm going to go, "Well, why are you glad?" Mm-hmm. Because there's something different about saying "I'm good" versus "I'm glad." There's a difference.
Wow.
And it lets people know there's something going on in your life.
Mm-hmm.
That's more than just the ordinary. That's mm-hmm. more than just the common. Because you talk to people all the time and you say, "Man, how you doing?" You say, "I'm doing good." And you say, "Okay, well, that's great." But anytime anybody ever uses the word glad and you say, "Man, how are you doing?" And they say glad, immediately something goes, well, what makes you glad? Because we know there's a difference there. And I think the difference can be found in Psalm 126, verse 3. It says this. It says, "The Lord has done great things for us, and we are glad."
Wow.
You know, I think that the difference between good and glad is goodness is connected to the past, and gladness is connected to the present. Mm. I think that's the big difference. I think that in our everyday life, sometimes we say we're good because maybe something good happened yesterday, maybe something good happened over the weekend, and we're still kind of trying to flow out of that moment and that goodness. But when you say "I'm glad," it's very present feeling. It's like, okay, God has done great things in the past, but the difference is what makes me glad is I know that everything that he has done is for right now and that he's doing something right now. And so I encourage you today to be glad. Don't be good, be glad. Don't live in what was, but know that God is doing something right now that you can be glad about.
Wow. So that's good. That's good. And one thing that, when you say that, one thing that should make you glad is also joy.
Mm-hmm.
Knowing that God has everything in control.
Yeah, absolutely.
Everything is in control. That's good, Pastor John.
Absolutely.
Man, you don't blow me away today.
It's just something simple, man, and we just want to encourage everybody with it today to just don't be good today. Be glad.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I mean, I know good is better than some of us feel anyway, so good is a step up. But let's take that next step, and let's don't be good. Let's be glad. And I just want to encourage you that God has done so much. I wrote some of this stuff down. I just read it the way that I wrote it. I said, you know, he has set us free from all the bondage, all depravity, all the foolishness, every bad decision we've ever made. He has come to set us free from that, so I'm glad. Mm-hmm. The past doesn't dictate my future. God's mercies are new every morning. The evil one will not get the last say, and the enemy will fall into the trap that he has set for us. For all those who love God and are called according to his purpose, everything is working out for our good. We have not out-sinned Christ. We have not out-sinned Christ's ability to forgive us. Christ will come back and he will claim his kingdom. And I am glad about that. So I just started to list things, man. The world, it may look just like a disaster to everybody, but there's a lot that we can just be glad about because of what Jesus has done and who Jesus is in our life today.
And the sin, our sin. I like what you said. We have not out-sinned Christ.
That's right.
That's enough to be glad.
That's enough to be glad about.
There's no sin. No sin that we can commit that will take away God's gladness or his hand off our life. Mm-hmm. That's right. Even, that reminds me of David. Mm-hmm. David, when he sinned, had an affair with Bathsheba. And one thing he said, Lord, don't take your Holy Spirit away from me.
That's right.
He had that much gladness in his heart at that present moment to know that although he has sinned, he was so glad to know that God would not take his Holy Spirit away from him.
That's right.
Because he deserved it.
That's right.
Yeah. Wow. I like that, Pastor John. Boy.
Well, thank you so much, man. We want to thank you guys for being with us. And I'm going to get Pastor Daravius to just pray for us.
Yes. Father, we thank you for this is the day that you have made. We will rejoice and be glad in it.
That's right.
God, we thank you right now. God, we're not going to look at the past, but we're going to look at the present. We have so much to be thankful for. Mm-hmm. Thankful for our use of our activity of our limbs and our job, our career, our church family. And Father God, as we go forth, God, let us be reminded that there's nothing we can do, no sin that's so great that you won't forgive us. We thank you, Father, and we are so glad, and we are looking forward to great things that you would do in our life. Yes. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen, man. We want to thank you guys so much and just again encourage you to leave this moment right now and go and tell someone, say, I'm not going to be good, I'm going to be glad. In fact, one thing that you can do to make this practical, the Bible says whatever things are good, whatever things are praiseworthy, you know, think on these things. So why don't you write something down in the comment bar? Why don't you comment somewhere and say, this is what I'm glad about, so that you can make it a practical activity in your life today. And then the last thing I'll do before we let you go is just remind you, man, Pastor Daravius has an amazing church, two locations. So if you're in the Elberton area or in the Lincolnton area and you're looking for a home church, one of the things about me, and I say this every single Sunday, is I'm not here to get you to come to my church. I'm here to get you to a church. And if it's not my church, I want to help you find an amazing church. And this is a man that I trust my life to. Wow. And if you are looking for a church to visit and you're trying to find somewhere to call home, true friendship, I'm telling you, you will love the people, love the not just Pastor Daravius, man. He's got some incredible people around him. I love Jeremy, his right-hand man. I just think he's got the greatest right-hand man in the planet. And so, listen, check these guys out, man, and go see what they got going on and get connected.
Before we go, I want to say I'm glad about our friendship,
Amen.
Our brotherhood.
Amen.
And one thing that I'm glad about, this let the community know and everybody know, it doesn't matter about color.
That's right.
Or anything. If you love God.
That's it.
And the love we have for each other. This is my brother.
That's right. Amen.
Have a good day, you
I
all.
Agree. Yeah, have an awesome day.
I'm glad.
Thank you for listening to 5Before, a faith community podcast. For more information, check us out at faithcommunitylc.com or look for our app on iTunes and in the Google Play Store.